Very good morning to everyone. So I have a screw gauge in my hand today and a wire. So I'll be showing you how to use a screw gauge to find the thickness of the wire. Let's go through the parts of the screw gauge. Here we can see the parts of the screw gauge. Let us begin with the experiment now. Let's check whether the screw gauge has zero error or not. So the main scale zero and the circular scale zero has to coincide, but here it is not coinciding, so it means there is a zero error. So you can see the first, second, and third line. The third line is coinciding to the zero, so it is plus three error. It has a plus three error now. So I'll be showing you into the table now how to correct the zero errors. As you saw, it has a plus 3 zero error. So for the correction of this zero error, you have to do minus 3. So I'll be showing you this to use in a table. So later on. Okay, let's find the least count of the screw gauge provided to us. To find the least count, I will require the pitch of the screw gauge. So here the pitch, I'll show you how to find. So let's start the reading with, as it has a error, it is starting with the third divisions in a circular scale. So you can see that. Now I'll rotate it 5 times. So first, second, third, fourth, and the fifth time. So I'll align the third line. Now you can see the main scale has three readings, right? So main scale has three readings, which you can see here. The main scale has three readings. And how many rotations I did? I did 5 rotations. So 3 by 5, which is 0.6 millimeter. Now to find the least count, we will require pitch by the number of circular scale divisions. So the pitch we got is 0.6 by, let's see how many circular divisions are here. It has 35, 40, 45, and then 0 comes. So 50, which is 0.6 by 50. That will be 0.01. So this is the table. You can see the table here. This is the table. So we'll be recording the findings here as we are finding the thickness of this wire. So I'll place this wire in a screw gauge and then rotate with the sachet here. Okay, let's take the reading. The reading shows here. You can see it. So it is 32. So it is 32 now. The reading shows here is 32. So I'll record the readings in a table. So it is a circular scale reading. Circular scale reading is 32, and the main scale is, just see the main scale reading. I can see only 0 in main scale reading. So the main scale reading, it's 0 for the first reading. So the next we have N into LC. The N we have is 32 into LC is 0.01, which will be 0.32, and the observed diameter here is N 0 plus N into LC is 0.32, right? 0.32. So, and the corrected we have to subtract the corrected one, 0.03. So here it will be 0.03 0.32 minus 0.03, which is equal to, so 32 minus 3, 0.29. Yeah, so this is our first reading, 0.29. so similarly we will do all the 5 readings in a table, and I'll complete this table and will show to you. Similarly, I have repeated the experiment for the 5 times. I got the 5 readings, so which is, first was 32, 31, 31 again, 32 and 31, and I calculated the thickness. Doing all the calculations, I got these readings here, and next to this I calculated the average. I calculated the average diameter, which I added 5. All 3 divided by 5. So the average thickness or average diameter of the wire was 0.284 millimeter.